Guys, this is Damian Cryer. This time I am going to just run this video until either the camera dies or it starts raining. I just heard some thunder, so hopefully I can bring us something nice today. It is actually late evening time. I'm assuming it's about 5:30 or 6 o'clock p.m. I heard just a little bit thunder in the background. So right now, I am still out here doing my thing. I got two poles in the water right now, and I'm still at it. I'm still doing this catfish thing. I want you guys to tell me in the description down below if you want me to do bluegill fishing tomorrow, crappie fishing tomorrow, or bass fishing tomorrow. Actually, I have jigs. I brought a set of jigs with me. I have to get them out of this box. Hopefully, while I'm showing you guys these lures, hopefully something that grab one of these poles and bend it. So right here, this is Darian's little stash right here, guys. My son, Darian. This is his little stash right here. I don't know why, but for some reason, Darian is like his brother, Deontay. You guys know Deontay's situation. But Darian, he's a lot like his big brother. He likes to use jigs to fish with. He does not like to use live bait. I don't know if it's because he don't like to touch worms or anything, but just to show you guys some of the jigs that he likes to use, he has this one, which is his favorite one. Actually, I'll get two, show you guys why. When we go to lakes for bluegills and crappie and bass, Darian likes these little jigs right here. These are little bluegill jigs. Because of the background, hope you guys can see that. That's a green one. I'm actually looking. You probably wonder why I'm looking back and forth like this. It's because I'm talking to you guys and I'm trying to keep an eye on both of the fishing poles to make sure one doesn't get pulled in the water. It is some big fish in here. Anyway, this is the green one and this is the white one. Because of the background, they both almost look like the same color, but they're actually different. So you actually put the hook in right here, and this part actually spins through the water as you're pulling it in. And I can see why a fish would be attracted to something like that. That's like a small jig. Same one. Based on water conditions, you want to use different colors. So, for instance, I'm fishing in a river water right now. So you want to use the white one. Because in murky water like this, a fish could actually... Hold on, guys. I think we're getting a bite here. Actually, we're getting bites on two poles, guys. This is awesome. Oh, wow. We got a double whammy. I got him. Yep, I got him, guys. This is so cool. This is a nice one, too. And guess what? I'm getting a bite on pole number two. I'm getting bites on both of them. I was hoping that this was going to happen. You can't really stage this because you can't tell a fish when to bite. He's a little fighter, too, guys. He's got some muscles. He's shaking that head. Oh, yeah. Splashing around. Look at that. Look. Look. Look how he's hooked. That's crazy. Look, the other pole is still biting. Look how he's hooked. The line wrapped around his fin. I think we're finna get another one, guys. So, remember, you grab the catfish like that so these little stingers doesn't poke you. And you have to kind of work the hook out of his mouth. You have to twist and pull a little bit, and then finally, bang, release it. So, there we go. We have another channel catfish. Nice, pretty, healthy catfish. I'm gonna put it close so you guys can actually hear how it makes that little grunt noise. Oh, he jumped out of my hand. Okay, so we got another one. So I'm going to put another worm on the hook and we're gonna throw it back out there. See if we can get another one on camera. It's better to catch them while you're filming because you guys could actually see me in action pulling the fish out. But I wanna really get a big one, like a 5 or 6, even a 10 pounder. so you guys can see just like a 10-minute video, the whole video of me actually fighting this thing and bringing it in. And believe it or not, guys, when I tell you it's some big ones in here, it is some big ones. It's just this time of day, I came too early. This one is really acting up, guys. I think he might, I'm gonna see if I can set it real quick and see if I can get him. Again, guys, this is catch and release today. I'm not keeping these fish. I'm putting them in the bucket as I catch them, because at the end of the vlog, I could actually do a count of how many fish I caught in the amount of time that I was here fishing. Again, guys, I'm fishing today in Fort Wayne, Indiana. I'm at Shove Park off of St. Joe Road. It's a very big park. Today, Darian's not with me. I know a lot of people's wondering where Darian's at. Darian is actually staying a night with his friend James tonight. He stayed last night. I guess they wanted to play football today and go to the church and do some other things. So he's not fishing with me today. I'm going to be, oh, he's biting, guys. I'm on vacation for the next 2 weeks. So the next 14, 15 days, I will be off work. I'm going to be keeping Darian home from daycare a couple of those days. And we're going to be hitting some pretty big lakes, guys, using some of these jigs that I showed you. A lot of these jigs, again, are Darian's jigs. He likes to use jigs instead of real bait. Again, I think he doesn't like touching real worms because they're slimy. So, well, that's where we're at, guys. This little fish just stopped biting. So, I may have to pull this line in and check it and throw it back out there and see what happens. Okay, guys, now that we got that catfish off the line, I'm going to go back and continue the lures that Darian, my 9-year-old son, likes to use when we're fishing. And hopefully, again, while we're going over the lures that Darian likes to use and why, hopefully we can get another bite. And hopefully it's a big one this time. So, right here, this is an artificial worm. This is an artificial worm. Again, he uses these on lakes, and these are very effective. He catches a lot of bass with these. He's actually caught a couple smallmouth bass with these lures. And if he decides to use these when we go out Monday or Tuesday, since I'm on vacation, we're gonna actually film him actually pulling a bass in with one of these worms, okay? Now, we have these right here. I'm not 100% sure what these are called, because when you buy them, they actually come in a pack. I don't know if you can see this good. These are really good for crappie fishing. You just put them on a hook and you kind of pop them up and down in the water. And these little things right here is what attracts the fish. They go really crazy over this movement in the water. So imagine if you're sitting on the water. Now this is just the wind I heard blowing. So imagine if you're sitting on the water and the water's actually moving. These little things are just going crazy in the water. And they're extremely attractive, attracting fish and prey. Guys, look like we're getting a bite on number two. And again, this right here is a white twister tail. I showed you some earlier that was something similar. Same thing, these are much bigger for much bigger prey. I think the ones I showed you earlier were this. You see the difference in them? This is more bigger and more thicker on the right. And the one in my left hand is much smaller, not as flexible as the one on my right. The one on my right is more bigger, but you want to use these right here, the bigger ones on my right. And uh-oh, guys, here we go. It's going down. It's going down. Let's see if we can bring him on in. See, now that I dropped the artificial lure that I wanted to tell you guys about, the fish wants to start biting. When I put the lure down, it wants to stop biting. So we'll have to see what happens here. Hopefully I can get him, because he is really taking my bait right off my hook. Okay, guys, we got a big one. Yes, we got a big one, guys. It happened. Oh yeah, we got a nice one. We got a nice one. He's fighting. He's not really big, but he's a lot bigger than the three I got in the bucket. He fights like a catfish. Now he's close to the boat and he's just really, really, really pulling hard. You hear the fish finder going off? It's that time of evening. It must be after 6 o'clock because they're starting to really move in now. This is what I was saying in an earlier blog about the more later in the evening it gets, the more opportunities that you have. Oh, come on out here. Oh, look at that. That is a nice one. Look at that, guys. Look at the size of that thing. That is very, very nice. Channel cat. Remember what I said, when you grab it. Oh, guys, look, I got another bite coming. I can't even get this one off the line without the next one. They're biting like crazy now. It's going down here today at Shove Park. Anyway, I'm gonna wash this pole while I'm trying to show you guys how to properly remove this thing off the hook. Remember, make sure the whiskers are sticking out just like that so you don't get poked by one of these things. Catfish is a tough fish, so you have to jimmy that hook out of his mouth. Turn it around like that. Got the. Just pull that hook out. See the worm? He was getting it. Oh, he's a little fighter too. So guys, here we go. Oh, he jumped out of my hand. Okay, we got him. Again, guys, look at that. How nice is that? That is very, very nice. Really nice catfish right here. Again, the later in the evening it gets, the more the fish are going to become active because the sun is cooling off, which means the fish from the bottom are starting to come up to feed. This is like the best time for them to start feeding. So this is where we're at. We have another catfish, number six, guys, number six. So we're going to reset the bait, guys, and get back out there because they are really acting up. We may have to finish the artificial lure in the next vlog because we got a lot of activity going on right now. And we want to capitalize on it. So right now, guys, we are on channel cat number six. And they've been here about an hour and a half. You didn't see the first two catfish I got because I was filming from my blog camera, but I ran out of memory. So I'm sorry about this poor quality again, but I wanted to bring you guys something, you know. So right now I am getting a bite on the next. Okay, guys, this is probably going to be the end of this blog. I just got a phone call from home, so I have to go home and take care of something at home real quick. I think something's wrong with the washing machine, so I have to go home and fix it. So I'm one of those multitaskers. Not only do I work in a steel mill 10, 12 hours a day, not only do I love fishing, but I'm also handy with the hands. Gotta fix things at home, best way to save money. But until next time, guys, thank you for watching, and I promise you, I am going to get a bigger SD card today to bring you guys the best quality videos possible. Until next time, guys, thank you for watching. I'm Damien. Peace.